Hey everybody, welcome to another video. Hope everybody is doing great. Today I want to show you guys a card I've been wanting for a long time. Finally picked up a 1953 Topps Satchell Paige rookie. And this is a card I've been wanting in my collection for a long time now. This card is beautiful. It is, look at the color on this card, it really pops. But it does have a flaw, tiny pinprick, okay? A couple of years back, I did a video about my Nolan Ryan rookie that has a pinprick. It's one of the prettiest cards. Now, for me, this is gonna go into a PSA slab. It's gonna get a PSA 1, and it's gonna be nicer than 99% of the other Satchell Paige PSA 1s. And I'm really excited about it because I got this card for a pretty good deal because of the pinprick. It wasn't cheap, but it also wasn't too crazy. But I do have a little stash for when I do see something I really like. And here is something I absolutely just adore. This is one of the best cards. Just an amazing card of an amazing guy. And if you guys aren't up on Satchell Paige, there are a lot better sources of information than me, but you know, just go on to the Saber website, check that out, even Wikipedia. I mean, he's just one of the most historical, legendary people in the history of baseball. And I mean, just so happy to have this card. I can't tell you guys, this is truly, to me, it's kind of almost having like a 52 mantle. It's unfortunate we never saw what Satchell Paige would have done in his 20s, and that's really part of the true crime. You know, I mean, that's part of the worst of it, you know, to rob these guys of their true greatness, but you know, still not taken away from the great Satchell Paige. Also picked up these 1969 Transigram hand cut at a card show. These cards are just absolutely stunning to me. I love these cards. These are both authentic. These came from behind a figurine box. You know, it's a hand cut box panel, you know, as it were. And they had little, I'm gonna try to find one. I'll try to put it in the video. Little figurines of these guys, you know, the legends, you know, Tom Seaver, Willie Mays, some, you know, not everybody on there is that legendary as those two. And I wanted to show you guys what I'm going to be sending off to PSA with the Satchell Paige. It's about time I did another PSA sub for some vintage. These are the cards I'm going to grade. 54 Yogi. Here's the Phil Rizzuto, the Scooter. Also from the 54 top set, here's a 67 Gibby. That's another project of mine, is getting all Gibby's cards from his playing days. Here is the Fence Busters card. I've had this card forever, and I always wanted to sub this card. I just never do it. I don't know why I don't, whatever. And here's a 63 Casey Stengel. Anything Casey Stengel I see in a slab that I can afford, I buy. Old Mets logo is amazing, I gotta say. Really, really cool. This is a 69 Ernie Banks, just a beautiful card. You know, has some corner damage, probably has some surface damage, but look at how nicely centered this is. I'm not a huge fan of 62, but this Nelly Fox is a beautiful card, really sharp. And the background's pretty nice, even though you can't see it. The card, the photo's a bit dark on this one. 64 Yogi, great card, just a great looking card. This card's real sharp too, and very nicely centered, so I'm happy about that. The legendary Don Zimmer. Don Zimmer is a guy that if you're a Cubbies fan or a Red Sox fan or a Yankees fan, you'll probably really have a lot of love for the dude as a manager. Actually, some Red Sox fans may hate and despise Don Zimmer. I have no idea. But here is the great Mickey Mantle, 68 Topps game. Any Mantle that is in pretty good shape. This one's pretty nice, so I'm going to slab that. The Gaylord Perry rookie. Okay, the 63 Topps. Got a 62 Frank Robinson. That's another project I'm probably going to complete soon. 59 Topps Frank Robinson All-Star Selection card. The 64 Joe Torre. the 68 Topps game, Hank Aaron, the 1970 Topps. You know, I know this one's off-center and whatever, but speaking of not being off-center, check out this. We're going to end, boys, with two war heroes. Here's Hoyt Wilhelm, and I got a few of these Fleer Ted Williams joints. The one with him in the cockpit, man, come on, that card's incredible.